In this screencast, we're going to show how to use the heat of reaction method to solve for the energy balance. In other words, what is the Q that comes out of the reactor? So we have this reaction, and it goes in at 300 degrees C, and it comes out at 500 degrees C. And since we're using the heat of reaction method, the steps we need to do are first to do the material balance. However, since it is a heat of reaction method, it means we're going to have to use the extent of reaction method. Then we're going to put together an enthalpy table that has to include the references. And because we are using the heat of reaction method, our references have to be 25 degrees C, 1 atmosphere, and the molecular species. Because we use molecular species to find our heat of reaction. Once we've done that, we're going to input the enthalpies that are based on the temperature change. In other words, the change from a reference temperature of 25 degrees to 300 degrees C for our reactants and 500 degrees C for our products. Then we, using the heats of formation that we can find in any book, we calculate the heat of reaction. And finally, we calculate Q, which is this extent of reaction times the heat of reaction plus the sum of our enthalpies in the table. So this is out minus in. So let's start with doing our material balances. So let's say that we're given 1 mole of CO, 50% excess of H2O, which means we have 1.5 moles of H2O. Our conversion is 80%, so 0.8 equals moles of CO in, moles minus moles of CO out, divided by the moles in, and that allows us to find the moles of carbon monoxide coming out. It also allows us to find the extent of reaction because the moles of carbon monoxide out equal the moles in minus the extent of reaction. The reason it is negative is because it is a reactant and we're using it up. Therefore, our extent of reaction is 0.8, and we use that to find the moles of our products. Finally, we have to find the number of moles of H2O, which is going to be the moles in, and again, it's a reactant, so we subtract the extent of reaction, and finally, we're left with 0.7. So now that we have our material balances taken care of, we put together our enthalpy table. So now we can fill in our enthalpy table. Notice our references at the top, 25 degrees C, 1 atmosphere, molecular species. So from our material balances, we know that we have 1 mole of CO and 1.5 moles of H2O coming in. None of this coming out. And then coming out of the reactor, 0.2, 0.7, 0.8, and 0.8. So the first things we're going to look at are the enthalpies in of carbon monoxide and H2O vapor. And because our reference is 25 degrees C, we can actually look in the enthalpy table for ideal gases for these enthalpies at 300 degrees. So this is 8.17 kilojoules per mole. This is 9.57 kilojoules per mole. And again, for the H outs, only this time we look at it in under 500 degrees. So that's 14.38, 17.01, 21.34, and finally 13.82. So we've put together our table. The next thing that we have to do is find our heat of reaction. So to find the heat of reaction, it's the sum of the heats of formation of the products multiplied by their each stoichiometric coefficient minus the sum of the heats of formation of the reactants, again, multiplied by their stoichiometric coefficient. And in our particular reaction, each of the stoichiometric coefficients are 1. So the heat of formation of carbon monoxide is minus 110.53. The heat of formation of H2O, and these are all vapor, is minus 241.83. The heat of formation of CO2 is minus 393.5. And again, these are all kilojoules per mole, and you can look them up in any table of physical properties. And the heats of formation of substances in their elemental form, such as H2, equals 0. So now let's calculate this heat of reaction. And so it's minus 393.5 kilojoules per mole minus 241.83 plus minus 110.53. Those are ours coming in. And our heat of reaction is minus 41.14 kilojoules per mole. And so now the only thing that we have to do is add everything together. So our Q is going to be, and let's go back to this table to show you exactly how we're going to use it. So we're going to use 0.2 times 14.38 plus 0.7 times 17.01 plus 0.8 times 21.34 plus 0.8 times 13.82. So that's our enthalpies times their moles out. And we're going to subtract from it 1 times 8.17 and 1.5 times 9.57. So let's do that. But we're not done yet because we have to add to that our extent of reaction times our heat of reaction. And so when we calculate this out, we find that our Q is minus 12.6 kilojoules.